Then there is a difference between direct tax and indirect tax. Features of indirect taxes we just discussed, right? Indirect taxes is more safer to collect from government perspective, because people who are paying indirect taxes and people who are complying the law are different. In income tax, what happens? You earn and you have to comply with the provisions of income tax department, and that's why people may manipulate. But in GST, person who is actually paying to department and person who has taken the burden is different. So actual consumer has paid money to supplier, and supplier is the responsibility to deposit with department. And that's why collection of indirect taxes is far easier than collection of direct taxes. Secondly, indirect tax department is proactive department, because they are doing reconciliation and everything on monthly basis. At least they are hoping that they will do it on monthly basis, okay? And GST system is such an advanced system that they had proposed, okay? Actually, it is not effective as of now, but you have to give some month to GST for implementation. Obviously, it is a server-based tax, okay? And that's why if you file your sale return, okay, I don't have to put a data in my purchase return. If you are a seller and if I am a buyer, if you upload your sales return, see, first return has to be uploaded as a sales return. So person who has sold good, that means somebody has purchased it, right? After 10 days you have to file purchase return. But when you file, when will you go for filing purchase return? The moment you log in, you will obviously see, already you can see in your account that purchase data has already been updated by department. You just have to cross verify it and upload it. So, you know, integration, can you say integration? That means even if I want to hide my purchase, can I hide it now? Even if you want to hide your sales, can you hide it now? No. Wo kaise hoga? Because if you do not put your sales data, I'll put my purchase data. Right? And purchase data and sales data has to be reconciled. Earlier in VAT, we had concept of ghost dealer. In VAT, we had concept of ghost dealer. Sir, what is the concept of ghost dealer? It's not technically ghost. Okay? Ghost dealer means dealer who is not in existence, but still you are having bill. And on that bill, you have paid VAT. And the moment you paid VAT, you have to get credit under VAT system. You used to book credit. Then department used to say, sir, this person is not in existence. You used to say that. So that is none of my business. You find this guy. I had original return. I paid the VAT. I had taken the burden. I need a credit. Whether that person files return or not, that is not my concern area. Yaar. See, I purchased goods from this shop. Right now I had paid VAT, I will book credit, I need benefit of this VAT paid, I'll file my return under VAT system, okay? But that person is run away, he shut down his business and he is not traceable now. Is it my default? You are a government, you can identify him, you can collect tax from him, you seize his bank account, you do whatever you want to do, but I need a credit. Am I clear? So this problem was there in VAT, okay, and that's why now GST is integrated, right? The moment you upload return, it will be reflected in buyer's account. The moment buyer's account puts your sales data, if you have not recorded sales data, then it will reflect in your account. And this integration will be done on a monthly basis, not on quarterly basis, not on half yearly basis, not on yearly basis, monthly basis. That's a key point. People are worried about their accounting system. In India, we do not do accounting system. Accounting system is weak. People were not serious about accounting and maintaining books of accounts and records. Now they are serious. And that gives scope to chartered accountants, company secretaries, cost accountant to maintain data, to file return, right? Or advocates for compliance matter. So these are things now that people are taking accounting seriously. People are taking taxation seriously. Have you ever seen before this year, like before 2016, people, general people discussing about tax? Nobody ever discuss about tax. Have you ever seen a new channel reflecting news on tax amendments or tax changes in the country? No. That means till 2015, I believe, nobody was even bothered that what kind of taxes we are paying in India. We have never seen any news on excise and service tax and VAT and custom and CST. But from the day when they had proposed GST, every day, every day. Forget about business niche channel. Business niche channel, so they are actually doing operations on GST. What is happening in GST, and what should happen in GST, what will be the impact, positive impact, negative impact, inflationary nature, this goods price will go up, this goods price will go down, this industry is benefited, this industry is not benefited. Business channels like ET Now, CNBC, these channels are, you know, putting data every day. But there are certain new channels who were never ever interested in financial news, right? So they were showing only murder cases and then robbery cases and then some small, you know, political issues. Those channels also are now displaying GST news. And that's a tax reform. That's the tax awareness. People know what is the GST now. People are mentally ready to pay GST. That's the impact of GST. So everybody knows now that we have to pay GST. Yesterday we had dinner in that Malwani Mela, you know, there is a, on this Pawai Road, right? We went there, you know, I was praying that, hey God, please, there should not be GST on at least these counters, right? Open counters, right? It's not AC restaurant. We had some food there. Whenever you go to restaurant now, you know, you feel that you are having dinner along with your friends plus central government and state government. If you have food for 1000 rupees, 90 rupees you will pay for central government and 90 rupees you are paying for state government. Obviously, are it pinch. If you see the bill, you know, 200, 300 rupees extra charges you are paying in a form of taxes, right? Earlier you were not paying. Service tax was there, no. VAT was there on this food contract, but people were not taking it seriously. Hotel owners were not taking it seriously. Now they had taken it seriously. And what government has explained them? See, I'm not taking money from you, yaar. What is your responsibility as a hotel dealer? You collect it from customers and pay. And nation is ready to pay the tax. Now nation is ready voluntarily or involuntarily, that doesn't matter. But nation is ready. See, we are also mentally prepared now, right? Now if you go to a restaurant, if you see that menu of 1000 rupees, you know that we have to pay 1000 plus 180. 18% if you take the rate. Okay. So we are mentally prepared now. That means people of India are aware that we have to pay GST. Apart from that, every restaurant, every trader shop, they are putting these holdings. Taxes extra, taxes applicable, 18% GST, 12% GST. So these boards are reflecting everywhere now. And that's why I say that GST is going to help in a building nation. Okay? Forget about building nation, GST is going to help us in earning money. If you earn money, that means people are earning money. Are why people are paying money? Because they are doing good business. If you do not do business, then will you pay GST? Are you paying GST? Are you GST registered person? No, why? Because we are not doing any business. That means if you start doing business, you need to get registered under GST. And that is a good news, right? You are doing your business and you are paying taxes. Nothing wrong in that. All right. Sure. Yeah. So let us come to the direct and that as features is discussed. Genesis of GST in India. Now, I don't know whether something from this paragraph may come in exam, may not come in exam. I'm 100% sure that IPCC people, you are not supposed to read this paragraph because it will not come in exam. This is general knowledge that what happened in GST. But CS executive people, you have to even buy her this because they may ask who had proposed GST. Okay. So, let us try and underline and find out some MCQs from this. It has now been more than a decade since the idea of national goods service tax was mooted by Kelkar Task 4. Now there are 2-3 famous bodies that you should understand, people, individual people who is having their own group. They are advisor to government of India. Okay. So Rajaji Chhelia Committee. Have you heard this word?
Yes.
Rajaji Chhelia Committee had proposed service tax in India and they implemented service tax. Okay. Then we had a Shom committee. Mr. Shom committee. They are working on direct tax matters. Okay. And Kelkar committee is a committee who are working on indirect tax reforms. All right. And who had proposed or who had given this idea of national tax. National tax means one tax for whole nation. One tax for whole nation. But actually what was proposed by Kelkar committee and what has been implemented is a different law. But at least we are having some common fundamentals now. So fundamentals were taken from Kelkar task force. All right? Sure? And what is the responsibility of Kelkar task force? To reform taxation system in India. So you may have, you know, objective in this MCQ pattern and you have to take Kelkar task force. They will give you multiple names. One of that name will be Kelkar task force. All right? Yeah. So this is the one MCQ that you can have. Subsequently, the Union Finance Minister P. Chidambaram Uncle, right, while presenting central budget in 7-8, announced the GST would be introduced in April 2010, and that was the first year when I heard GST from Anjay sir. Anjay sir prepared PPT in 2010 about GST. And that time I was not knowing what is GST. He is an advanced psycho. Are you? People of India are unaware about what is GST, and he prepared PPT on that. That how GST is going to impact India. That time he was like little bit crack. Now you can see improved version. But that time he was quite extra crack, you know. And that time he said that Ramji, you know what? VAT, service tax and excise will no more there. And I was worried because I was studying like you. Right, and I was very good in service tax here. I said, sir, service tax at least should be there. At least up to our exam. So we all prayed to God. God, please do not bring GST in 2010. God said, okay. It didn't come in 2010. We failed in 2010. God, please do not bring GST in 2011. God again listened. We again failed. Right? In 2012, again we prayed, God, this is last. Yeah, please listen to us and do not bring GST in India. God said, okay. And we cleared CIPCC. Okay, then we were in final, mentally ready to accept every changes in the country. But they changed the government. So in 2014, they changed the government. And existing government could not bring GST in India because they were not having support from other members of parliament. And then Modi uncle came in 2014, second part of 2014. And from that day onward, they are working on GST. Am I clear? In 2014, I cleared my CA final. So I was not giving any shit to any amendment. Because, see, as a chartered accountant, we are open to do anything. Yaar. Why to worry about GST? But fortunately, unfortunately, on July 2017, they brought GST in India. So whether this act was proposed in 2017, no, it was proposed long back. Right? 7-8. And in 7-8 he proposed by saying that by 2010 we should bring it. Alright? And you know what reality is? Why they did not bring it? There's a person, I don't know, there's a one person, chartered accountant, very famous, I forgot his name. Whenever some changes are made in any tax reform, in tax system, okay, the ICI has to give representation on it. So what is the process of government of India before making any such changes in a country? They appoint a committee, particular committee. So chairman, secretary and other members will be there. And that committee will listen a representation given by ICI mandatorily. Okay. In 2010, when they say that we are about to launch, and P. Chidambaram uncle was quite aggressive. He's an aggressive finance minister. He said, I don't care what happens in the country. I'm going to launch GST for sure. Then ICI said, but listen our story. They say that we will give you 5 minutes. And no matter what you say, whether you are positive about GST or negative about GST, still it is 100% sure that we are going to implement the GST in India. In 2012 this has happened. And then the person who was given a presentation only for 5 minutes, so they gave only 5 minutes to ICI representation, the biggest accounting body of India. And that person who had given, who was supposed to give presentation, we call him indirect tax Kida. You know Kida? Worm. Right? So he eats indirect tax. Every time he is in indirect tax. So he is a very famous personality in indirect tax. And he gave presentation for 3 minutes. Not even for 5 minutes. And they did not bring GST in India. with a 3-minute presentation, right? That means he must have said something valuable to the government. Yeah? And the point that I am trying to share today, is those are some points, which are common for everybody, but he shared it for first time. Okay? That if you bring GST suddenly in India, what will happen? And how will it impact India? And that's why one nation, one tax is a myth. It's not a fact. We cannot bring one nation, one tax. We don't have GST though. They just say one nation, one tax. It's one nation, 35 taxes. Okay? And GST, 31 GST act at state level. One at central level, integrated, and UTGST. So three are central level, CGST, IGST, and UTGST, and 31 at state level. And then there are some compensation and compensation says, and then one more amendment act, constitutional amendment act. So you, overall, if you want to understand GST, you have to study 36 acts. Under GST I am talking about, not under old system. Right? So one nation, one tax. They did not say one nation, one tax, one market, one act. One nation, one tax, one market, multiple acts. That is hidden thing, no? That you and me understands, right? People of India, they don't understand. Ah, one nation, one tax, one nation. No, Maharashtra government has own GST. Gujarat government has their own GST. But one nation, one tax is because of this. That provisions of Maharashtra government now are 99% same with Gujarat government. In earlier law, it was quite different. Maharashtra VAT was substantially different from Gujarat VAT. And Gujarat VAT was extremely different than Goa VAT. So people, like if you want to do tax practice in 2-3 states, that means your life was hell. Some item is goods in Maharashtra, whereas that item is not goods in Gujarat. That goods is a, you know, good commodity in some states, so they levy concessional tax. That goods is a bad goods, so they levy high taxes, like liquor. So liquor is bad in Maharashtra, liquor is bad in Gujarat, so they levy high taxes on it. But liquor is good in Goa. Welcome to Goa, right? 50% concessional price, almost 50%. It's not manufacturing cost 50%. Taxation matters where at 50%. That means your price is almost, like mean liquor that you purchase here for 1000 rupees, you could purchase easily at 500 rupees in Goa. If you go to a restaurant, have a coffee 60 rupees. You go to a restaurant, have a beer 50 rupees. You drink a Bisleri bottle 50 rupees. Bisleri beer. So, this happens in Goa, yaar. Why? Because of tax disparity. Tax was not in the same line. They had an object to make it in the same line, but was it in the same line? No. And that was another problem that we had in existing tax system or past, past tax system, and that's why they changed it to GST. GST, now if you are as a chartered accountant, if you understand CGST, one GST, at the same time, you will understand other GST Act. So, UTGST Act and any state. So, if you understand Maharashtra Act, you will understand Gujarat Act automatically. Because the 99% provisions are same. At least as of now. At least as of now. Ha, tomorrow, government of Maharashtra may change, government of Gujarat may change, and they may make some changes in GST. But at least today, it is 99% and in some state, it is 100% same. Exact, because see, state doesn't have that brain to have different GST Act. They are also fighting with the existing GST Act. What is this Act? Right? And later on they may bring some changes. But as of now, for your and my syllabus, even the question is on Maharashtra GST, if you write answer of central GST, your answer will be exactly same. Sections may be different from here and there. But majority sections are also same. Like section 9 in there, section 9 here. Section 5 there, section 5 here. Same. Series is also same. Okay. Yeah. So let us understand few more points. The talks of unsharing in GST, however, gained momentum in the year 2014 when India government tabled the constitution. Acha, they tabled means they tabled the bill. Table means, see, the people of parliament, they sit on chair, so they tabled the bill. Right? And what they do with bill? Right? I don't know what they do with the bill. This like they beat the bill, right? So they tabled what bill they proposed. So proposal was 122nd. Right? 122. Right? 122nd amendment bill. So which bill was proposed? 122. Okay, this is important. This data is important now. But bill which is passed. Can you see? Constitution 101 Amendment Act. See, bill was 122. Bill was 122. But the act which is passed is 101. I was confused. If you propose 122, then the act which is passed has to be 122, right? Or later somewhere. But they are saying that no, the proposal was in 122, but amendment was 101. So what happened? There might be multiple bills pending in constitution, a parliament. See, every minister proposed some kind of bill, right? So some bills are pending. One of that was 122. One of that was bill 122. Other bills are still pending. But 120 they had given a priority and they approved it at an earlier stage. Earlier point, and that's why. And some bill might be proposed in, it's not that every bill which is proposed is getting approved. So say for example 121 bill, I don't know, but I'm taking just data. 121 bill was there, but it was not approved in parliament. Okay, so that is gone. And that's why actual amendment which has taken place is 101. So GST came in India by 122 bill or 101 act. 101 Constitutional Amendment Act. Am I clear? Yeah. So both the data are important. Why both data are important? You should understand which bill was proposed. Bill. When they say bill was 122. Right? But the actual passed, act passed by parliament. How they passed act in parliament? Majority people should say yes. Majority people who had voted. Yes people should be more than negative people, right? So that thing is there. So in 2014 they proposed. Lok Sabha passed bill on May 2015. Rajya Sabha passed bill on 3rd August 2016. And subsequently, they did not call amendment. They called ratification whenever it is in terms of Constitution of India. See, act, changes in acts are known as amendment. Changes in a constitution is known as ratification. Okay, so subsequent to ratification of bill by more than 50% of states, Constitution 122nd Amendment Bill 2014 received the assent of the President on 8 September 2016 and became Constitution 101 Amendment Act 2016. See, I could not start these things without having background of Constitution that we discussed yesterday. So you should understand first of all what is the importance of Constitution in our acts. Any act, you take Company Act, you take any other random act, Constitution of India is the supreme law. Without approval of Constitution of India, I cannot bring any law in India. And where is that written? Article 265. No taxes can be levied or collected unless or except the authority of law. So by amending constitution, they first inserted a GST name in my constitution and then they propose GST Act. They propose, I say they propose, okay. When this bill was passed, some Nalayak news channel people were saying GST is approved, GST is approved. Right? Was GST approved on this day? Bringing GST proposal in India was approved. Constitution is ready to accept GST Act. Alright, understood, yeah. So that is Constitutional Amendment Act. So here is also important. In MCQ, how will they play? Constitution 101 Amendment Act 2017 and Constitution Amendment 101 Act 2016. Which one is right? But what, according to your logic, if you go, GST Act brought in India in 2017. So obviously majority people will click 17. So you should not go wrong. You should understand bill, constitutional bill was passed in 2016, whereas Act came into effect in 2017. And obviously you cannot be confusing dates. Why? Because I told you, First Amendment has to be taken place in Constitution and then Act. So 16 we changed Constitution, 17 we brought Act in India. It cannot be vice versa. You cannot bring Act in India and then pass Constitution Amendment Bill. Okay, very good. Intelligent people here, I don't know how you understand everything that I say. Sometimes I don't understand what I say. You people are so intelligent. In the following year, 27 March 2017, the CGST legislation means law. Legislature means people who make law. Right? Legislation, Central Goods and Service Tax Bill 2017. So bill was 2017. Okay. Integrated Service Tax Bill 2017. Union Territory Goods and Service Tax Bill 2017. Goods and Service Tax Compensation to States Bill 2017 were introduced in Lok Sabha. So how many bills count? Can you count the number of bills? Number of bills? Four. Very good. That means at central level they are making four act. At central level they are making four act. Okay. Because four bill were presented in Parliament. Are you knowledge? Who makes law for central whole country? Parliament. So when I say law was presented in Parliament, that means those laws are for states or for country as a whole?
Country as a whole.
Then what must have happened at Maharashtra? Maharashtra government must have presented one bill. Where? Vidhan Sabha. Churchgate. Beta, you are getting my point? Sir, bill was, central government has present bill in Parliament, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. But state government was also presenting bill. Where? Vidhan Sabha. Right? State Legislative Assembly. And this must have happened in every state. That means how many states we have in India? 29. Okay? That means on the during that March month, 29 states had their 29 act. And central government has proposed 4 act. Now what kind of 4 act they have proposed? CGST, IGST, UTGST and compensation to state. Am I clear? So these four bill were presented at Parliament. And SGST bill cannot be presented at Parliament. Why? Because state bill has to be presented in State Legislative Assembly. Why? Because it is written in Article 245. If you ask me why we have discussed yesterday. Okay. But I said, sir, 29 is the wrong number. Right number is 31. Why? Because we are having two states, we are having two union territories which looks like states. One of that is Delhi. Delhi is not a state. It's a union territory. But it has own legislature assembly. If they have their own legislative assembly, that means they can pass law for themselves. But Dadra Nagar Haveli is such a small union territory that they could not have their own legislative assembly. So for Dadra Nagar Haveli, right, law will be passed by central government. So there are seven union territories. General knowledge. There are seven union territories. Out of seven, two are very big. One is Delhi. Second one is Puducherry. Now spelling, you have to change, you have to learn new spelling also. It's not Pondicherry now. It's Puducherry. P-U-D-U and cherry. Cherry already, no? But not Pondicherry. We know it by name Pondicherry. Now we have to say Puducherry. Right? Delhi, and why? That you should not ask me. You go and Google out why Puducherry, why not Pondicherry? I cannot explain the logic of everything. Okay? So why not Mumbai? Why not Bombay? Why Mumbai? I don't know. Some Shiv Sena has done it. Some Shiv Sena people had done it. Okay. Now they are earlier these. It was VT, no? They now GST. Why? Now people outside India, they don't understand what is GST. When we say GST, they understand, okay, central sales tax. We said no, Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal. So, yeah, I said once that I went to CST. They said, sir, how can you go to CST? CST, central sales tax. I said, no, beta, Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal. Then they asked me, who is Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal? What is Chhatrapati Shivaji? We understand who is Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal. Whole India doesn't know about it. Right? And specifically South India, yaar. They have their own kings, no? You know who is the Kempe Gowda? So they know who is Kempe Gowda because their airport name is Kempe Gowda Airport. King of Karnataka, almost. Like Shivaji Maharaj, I can say. So we don't know stories about their king. They don't know stories about our king. You know how difficult it is to translate in English? What do you mean by Chhatrapati? Shivaji is the name, but Chhatrapati is not name. I thought for some time and they said, I'll get back to you. So two union territories who can make bill? Because they have their own, what is the logic they can make bill? They have their own legislative assembly. So 29 actual states and two union territories, but will you consider them as a union territory now in GST at least? So what is your general knowledge? If I ask you, beta, generally how many states are there in India? 29. Beta, how many states are there in GST? 31. Because after, now I know, do you know name of 29 states? At least major one. So Rajasthan is not a country, it's a state. You know that? Kerala, we call it God's own country. That's their statement, but it is not a country, it is a planet for me. I behave like an alien there, right? But for Constitution of India, Kerala is a state. So Kerala, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Assam, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, many things are there, right? So there are some small states, big states, average states, many things we have. 29 states, they have their own legislative assembly, they can make law for their own, themselves. Apart from that, two chota-chota union territory, which looks mota-mota state, two mota-mota union territory, which looks chota-chota states, yeah? So Delhi and Puducherry, they have their own legislative mechanism, so they can make laws for themselves. They had made laws for themselves. Their law cannot be called as UTGST. Their law is known as SGST. Because they act like a state, they walk like this, they talk like a state, they behave like a state. They have their own state police. They are not state. They behave like a state. For you, for your heart, you should explain, beta, all is well, all is well, all is well. 31 state. Yeah? Understood? For you and me, we should understand 31 states in India. Matter ends. That means tomorrow there will be MCQ in your exam. The law which is there, GST which is there in Delhi is IGST, UTGST, CGST, HGST. HGST. They do not pay UTGST Act. Acha, so out of 7, 2 are gone in state structure. So 5 are there. Right? So 31 states is equal to 31 law. One central government is equal to one central law. Balanced by union territory is equal to one union territory law. Why? Are they don't have assembly to pass their own law, their law will be passed in parliament. We don't have Dadra Nagar Haveli, Union Territory Act. No. UT Act is a UT Act for small UTs. Are we clear? Do not write, everything is written. Everything is written there. Do you people think that these are important things and it is not written somewhere? and I am sharing it from my own heart that beta this happening. Even I came to know about this in GST Act. That means it is written in GST Act, it is written in your modules, it is written in printed material. Why you people take extra effort to write everything I say? And do not write my jokes, huh? I have copyright on that. Copyright. Sir, so these were acts were passed. And President Assent. President Assent means? Sign. Very good. Achha, who is the head of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha head? We know everybody who talks to, people they talk to them, like if they want any approval, they call it Madam Speaker. So Speaker, people feel that Speaker is a head. No, Speaker is not a head. Speaker is acting on behalf of, who is the head of Parliament, Nalayak's President. Who is the head of Parliament? President. Who is the head of State? Governor. Okay. I cannot teach you this much general knowledge because I don't have more than this. Okay. For extra general knowledge,
yes, sir.
Even I go there, you know. Anjesh, he kya hota hai re? So I ask him once, who is the Madam Speaker, yaar? Why people are having so much respect towards her? Like, we don't know, right? People who are sitting in the first chair, and I ask him, every minister is taking approval from that guy. That means that guy must be a very important guy. And we never know about that guy. See, you know who is the President of India, you know who is the Prime Minister of India, but we don't know who is the President in Lok Sabha and who is the President in... Now, some people know they are psycho like Anjesh, sir. But ordinary people, we don't discuss about speaker in a... chairperson in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Because that guy is not acting on behalf of his own duties and powers. That guy is acting on behalf of President. He is a representative of President. Then where is the President, sir? Are President is very busy man. Yaar. He has to go there for inauguration, cut ribbon. And if he doesn't have, then sit in fighter plane and roam around the country. And then he can also go to foreign countries for having dinner and lunch. President is very busy person in India. And then they give some act. Sir, this act is approved in Parliament. Ha, okay, sorry. And then they are, kam se kam bata to kya tha ho, sir. Sir, GST. So, sir, the enactment of Central Act was followed by enactment of state GST law by various state legislatures. What is written there? Various states. It is not written various states parliament because state doesn't have parliament. Very good. Telangana, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Punjab, Goa, Bihar were among the first ones to pass their respective state GST law. Now this is general knowledge. Last one was Jammu Kashmir. France was the first country. Oh, this is copied from CS book. These Nalayak people, they have global scenario of GST. Are we don't understand domestic scenario of GST. And they had written whole page on global scenario of GST. So France is an important country. Okay. Because they introduced GST in 19... So MCQs, come on, right? This is again not for IPCC. In MCQ they may ask, which country has proposed or passed a GST bill, you know, for first time in the history? France, very good. Because we don't know any other country. And now today, almost 150 countries have introduced GST. Now some country doesn't have name GST, some country use name as a VAT. Value added tax. हाँ तो चलेगा कोई problem नहीं है चलेगा. This is from CS module ना. 150, 160, 180 that is not almost word means that is not exact count. Exact count we cannot take. See when they write with a caution. They know that there are people like this. They can Google out. हाँ so almost they said almost right. Almost 150, 160 country today they have GST. I'm saying that every country doesn't have name as a GST. Some countries call it value added tax. This is a value added tax only. GST is a value added tax. How? I'll prove it now. My name is not value added tax, but it is a value added tax. GST is a value added tax. Okay, conceptually. Then did in Brazil, Canada follow dual system. Most of the country have unified GST. That means every country has one nation, one tax, one market. And you know, some countries are having one rate also. You buy milk, 7% GST. You buy liquor, 7% GST. So there is no difference between liquor and milk. You buy cloth, 7%. You buy TV, 7%. No confusion in the country. You buy anything, 7%. Rate is simple, law is simple. One country, and those countries should say, one nation, one tax, one market, one rate, one act. Simplified, people are not confused because there is no scope of confusion. Here, one country, 29 states, two union territories deemed to be states. Balance five union territories are union territories, but they don't have, they cannot pass their act, so their act will be passed by parliament. Right? Then there is a, if you sell goods within the state, you pay CGST, pay SGST. Right? If you sell goods from one state to another state, do not pay CGST, do not pay SGST, pay IGST. And IGST is the invention in India. None of countries having IGST. India is the first country, I believe. Kuch to kiya hum log ne. Okay. So we don't have dual system. They say dual system. It's not dual system, yaar. Dual system means two act. I can still absorb two acts. Look at the list of acts that we have to study. Alright. Concept of GST we had discussed yesterday. I just said GST is a... Can you see that next word? GST is a... Value added tax. Sir, it is a selective approach or comprehensive approach? Comprehensive. Sir, it is only 1% will pay tax or whole chain will pay tax. Whole chain means, you know, goods will be manufactured by manufacturer. It will be given to distributor. Distributor will go to wholesaler. Wholesaler will give to retailer. Retailer will give to retailer 2 or retailer 3. And then it will reach at a consumer hand. Every sale is covered under GST. We are going to discuss that. And this is not new. Come on, people who had studied VAT with me, they already know that chain. We used to call it as a VAT chain, today we have to call it GST chain. VAT industry was following this continuously. The only effect is with now service industry. See, we had concept in VAT as intrastate supply and interstate supply. We already had that concept. But we were not having any concept in service tax as interstate and intrastate. Why? Because service given in Maharashtra, service tax. Service given in Gujarat, service tax. But now it is changed. Why? Service given in Maharashtra, CGST, HGST. Service given to Gujarat, IGST. We did not have this concept there in old system. Okay. So now it is intrastate of sale of goods as well as intrastate supply of services. Inter also. So intra services. This inter services were not there. Interstate services were not there in existing system, old system. Alright? Yeah, very good. You people are so intelligent again. Some people are still confused. I can see their faces. And who bears the burden of the GST?
Consumer.
That's what we had yesterday discussed. It is on consumption. Right? GST is on consumption. Final consumer. See, everybody pay GST. Every seller pays GST, but the ultimate burden is on consumer, okay? And sir, GST has taken utmost care of, there should not be no tax on tax. There should not be no tax on tax. We had discussed this concept in income tax, right? There should not be double taxation. Tax on tax means double taxation. In indirect tax, they do not call it double taxation. In indirect tax, they call it cascading effect. It's not cast cutting effect, huh? Cascading effect. T is missing there. Some people write cast carding. What is cast carding? Right? Cascading effect. So T is not there. Cascading effect. What is cascading effect? Tax on tax. Sir, what is these words? Now old people, they understand what is cascading. New people, I believe that you don't understand what is cascading. English, sir, we know that now. It is cascading. Tax on tax. I'll prove on board that look at the cascading effect and how VAT has resolved it. So cascading effect was already resolved in 2004 under VAT system. value added tax system, the still there has to be some remained tax on tax. See, we had already changed our India's indirect tax system to the best system in 2004, and that was white paper law, value added tax, and that was the best indirect tax reform that I believe. I must have said on last batch also that VAT is the best system that doesn't have any deficiencies, but still VAT was having some deficiencies. Okay, and specifically from international level and domestic level, country as a whole level. See, VAT was perfect for Maharashtra, but VAT was not perfect for government of India, and it was not perfect for foreigners also. Okay, and that's why GST. Clear? So what we have to discuss today, I'll teach you old system before VAT, what happened, and then I'll tell you what happened in 2000 era when they introduced VAT, and VAT was the best system, I believe, right? And now what happened in 2017? So before, like 1990s era, 1970s era, then 2000 era, and now 2017. So I'll teach you past, then past, then past, then past, and then present. So four past, four changes taken place in past, and then what happened at fifth level now. And let me tell you, and even this GST is not a perfect one. After some year, they may change even this GST. This is how evolution happens, right? We cannot change laws overnight, suddenly. So they change some parts over the period of time. And today you will witness that. Okay, so this is how they invented the concept of GST. So we'll go into invention of GST, how they had invented the concept. Actually, technically it is not invented in India. We do not invent anything. We go abroad. We think, "Achha, you are doing this," and then we do research in India. And while doing that research, we invent something. Invent means we understand that what is happening there, and then we bring it in an Indian culture. Foreign laws, we mix with Indian culture, and then we bring something new. So whatever acts we have in India are Indian invented law, but they follow certain mechanisms from foreign countries. So GST originally was invented in France. But our GST and France GST is completely different. But concept we have taken from foreign countries. Right? Not from France, but many. Now, France invented and then many countries followed it. Almost all developed countries are having now GST. And now India is one of them to adopt GST. Right? So if you look at global level, now global players are comfortable with India. Why? Because they have GST in their country. And we have GST in our country. So now they know what is GST. Earlier what was happened? What used to happen? They have GST in their country. One nation, one tax. In our country, manufacture, excise. Import, custom. Sale, VAT. Intrastate, VAT. Interstate, CST. Local authority used to say entry tax. Then octroi. Foreign people were confused. Yeah, how many taxes you people are levying on me? Right, at least give me number of taxes that we have to pay in India. Number of taxes, they were worried about number of taxes. And then India is dirty, then apply. Swachh Bharat says, new tax. Are Swachh Bharat says was new tax. Right, Ganga is not clean. Okay, clean Ganga says. Huh? Farmer committed suicide. Okay, Krishi Kalyan says. That means for every nonsense thing you are bringing, right? People are not educated. Education says. Now people are educated, but they are not having higher education. Okay, secondary and higher education. Look at GST also. Compensation says. Because of GST, some state will suffer loss. It was the responsibility of central government to give them compensation. So central government means they should give money from their own pocket, no? These nalayak people, they said, "See, we have to give them compensation, but we have nothing." Launch new tax, compensations to states. So under GST also we are having compensation. See, idea was only GST. But are we paying only GST? No. That's a problem. Okay, that's a problem that we have. Okay. Yeah, stealing GST. But I'm not going to discuss problems in GST. I'm going to discuss today problems in existing system. Existing system, you should understand. Existing means I'm talking about up to 30th June 2017. And then we will enter into GST. Alright? And that's what I said no yesterday. It is very difficult to teach new old people new law. Because they understand old law. And it is very difficult to teach new law to new student because they did not understand old law. So today I'll try to bring you at same platform. Okay. For new people, it will be new first time, old law also. And for existing people, they already know existing law, it will be revision for them. And now you will tell me what are the problems in existing system. You will identify and you'll tell, ha sir, this was a problem, this was a problem. Alright. Deficiencies, next point is that only deficiencies in existing value-added system. Chiju, pause it for 5 minutes, I'll clean my board.